Hi. Hey, I was gonna make a video explaining each supplement, what it does, and why I take it, but then that is such an overwhelming thing because I've researched so much, and to tell you exactly all that information just is just, I mean, because I'm sick too, you gotta remember. So what I did is I, in my blog, which I'll put the link to underneath, it has each supplement vitamin that I take and the whole fact sheet on each one. So you'll go through and all of them that I posted today, each vitamin supplement has its each, like zinc, it's its own post. And then my mega digestive enzyme has its own post, so they go down like that because it was just too much information to try to put in a video and it's too overwhelming. I mean, I wrote it all down and everything, and some of the things that I'm taking, in order for that one to work, you need to take another one. So now that information I can give you to the best I can. I'm struggling, I'm doing the best I can today, but folic acid needs the riboflavin, which is vitamin B2. Let's see. Okay, niacin B3 is for lowering my cholesterol and recycles the riboflavin. B6 needs magnesium to be effective. B12 needs folic acid. And the use of birth control pills increases the need for B12 and folic acid. And folic acid needs vitamin C to be effective. All right, Inosol for lowering my cholesterol needs to be taken with vitamin C, E, biotin, and chlorine. Chlorine, C-H-O-L-I-N-E. Okay, now let me see. And magnesium goes with the E, and of course I do the magnesium with the calcium. Niacin is more effective with E and C. Alright, I'm trying to see if I've got it all written down here. Alright, that's all I have written down, and it's so overwhelming, and without sounding rude, I'm just going to say it to you straight out. I'm not going to do all the work for everybody when I'm sick too and then just hand you the information. So you need to do some research and be proactive in your own health. Otherwise you have no right to lay around and just bitch about it, because if you're not going to do anything about it. So I'm going to be helpful, but at the same time you've got to research stuff. Some of the supplements that I'm taking are to lower my cholesterol naturally, and they work. And so I do stuff in my diet too, and it works. Some of it is being proactive because cancer runs in my family, and so some of it is fighting cancer. So each one has its own purpose. And this book here, I researched and I went online and stuff, but this book here helped me get where I'm at now, that and common sense. So, but you can't just sit there and expect for everybody else to do the work for you. And I don't mean to sound ornery about it, but sometimes I feel like that's what people want. All right, I worked hard and I've been sick for 15 years. I've been really sick for 13. And I've put a lot of time into this. So, I'm going to give you the information on the vitamins. And I don't want to hear people complaining about, that's so much reading to do. Well, do you want to get better? You need to be educated on each one, what it's for and stuff, to figure out which one that you need. And that's just the harsh reality. You need to do it. You need to put in the work. Even if you're sick and it takes you forever. I mean, 13 years, and I'm finally on the right track of having some good days and stuff. But don't expect for it to be handed to you. I'm going to give you the information as much as I can, but that's so overwhelming, and I'm not a doctor, and you need to research it. You do. You just need to. It's just the harsh reality. Now, I also use vitamin C cream in my face, And I take vitamin C orally, and I think that's part of the reason I haven't gotten the cold again that my granddaughter keeps getting and getting and getting. And I also use teas. But like I said, I've researched for 13 years now, and trial and error. So below I will have the link to my blog. And yes, it's a lot of reading to do because there are a lot of supplements. And it's Sapphire and Iron at blogspot.com. And I showed you the book, but I'll put a link for the book down below. And then I'll put a link down below for the vitamins, again, where I get them all, and supplements. So they're not all just to fight myalgic encephalomyelitis. There's for cholesterol and to fight cancer, too. And then in this book, it'll take you through stuff like, a sane approach to free radicals. Cholesterol, diabetes, arthritis, and you know the arthritis, you read through there because it might be able to give you some supplement ideas for your restless legs and stuff, which I have found, and your pain. And then in the back here of this book, it goes through listing the vitamins and what foods can provide them, a suggested supplementation, and then it goes through and it tells you each vitamin and the amounts. But those are just a guideline because you've got to educate yourself more to really see how much of it you need, and hopefully you have a doctor who's open to these things that you can talk to about. That goes through the trace elements, and it goes through each of the vitamins like this and tells you what other supplements you need to take in order for that one to work if you need to take them in as a combination. So, alright, I hope you guys find this helpful because there's no way I can go into each one and what they do and what combination they've got to be put together. I thought I could, but it's just too much. It's just too much for me. This was a lot just to do this that I've done. So, all right, I hope everyone has a great rest of the week. My daughter's out of school, so I probably won't be on here much. And she's out of school Friday and Monday, so I probably won't make another video Monday either. So this will be my video for next week. All right, any discussions, you know, make a video response, put them below. All right, peace.